Morning everyone, this is Vineet Pandey. A very good morning to all of you. And before we go for our today's topic, literary theory, formalism, Russian formalism and French formalism, I would like to ask you to go for attendance. All the online students, write your badge number and your state and your name and say online student. Means if you are from Delhi, write your name Rahul, Delhi online batch 2, December batch 2, August batch 2, whatever the batch you have, you can simply write this much and online student. And all the new students, those who are watching me for the first time or not our online student, they can simply write new students. We welcome them.
Achha, ispe video nahi aa raha, ispe only comment aa rahe hain. Theek hai, theek hai, aa rahe hain.
Now I can see students and comments. And all the students who are from the fresh batches of August. Remember this thing, when we will teach you literary theory, you will be getting each and everything once again. Now I am visible to all of you. Thoda internet problem ho sakta shayad. Devashish, Anaswarak from Kerala, Uday Kumar. Bahut badhiya. So, how many of you are scared of literary theory? How many of you feel that literary theory is something very scary, very dangerous, and it's like something you are not able to understand in an easy way? Do you know when I started preparing NET exam, then I got to know that something called literary theory exists. I didn't know about literary theory in my entire post-graduation. We just knew about literary criticism. Okay, beech mein chat because of internet issue, I'm not visible sometimes. Video stop ho gaya raha shayad. Chal raha hai. Okay, so today we'll be talking about literary theory. The point will be that why literary criticism to literary theory a shift. Why we went for scientific approach. Second thing, how literary theory has a difference from the literary criticism. What is the literary criticism concept? The limitations, then literary theory. And in literary theory, what is formalism and how it got divided in two different parts, two different streams, Russian formalism and French formalism. So I'll suggest you keep a pen and copy with you. And yes, in coming future, like in coming days, I will teach you the same thing using the board. So that I can draw some pictures, I can draw some words, lines, and I can help you to exactly understand the point that I want to say. So keep the copy and some notebook with you so that you can write down things. Apne paas copy likh lo. Tashu, if I could not reply, please WhatsApp me on 8810289637. I don't get chance to reply each and every one. That's my limitation. I try to reply, but sometimes I'm busy, packed up, and I find issues and I'm not able to reply. So just one more minute for attendance, one more minute, and we will start our literary theory class. So hurry up, students from Hyderabad, very good. Bahut badhiya Sunidhi, bahut badhiya. Answer karna class mein. Pinku ji, kaise hain aap? Pinku Shekhawat, aap apne sister ko mera namaste kahiyega. Anita Kumari ji, Delhi se hai, most welcome. Anil, main Rajasthan mein hu, I'm in Rajasthan. Haryana se Ram Ram ji. Ifa Siddiqui, kaise hai aap? Kritika Datta, West Bengal, kaise hai? Hello Mohammed Samreen, same here. Parveen ji, kaise hai aap? Usha ji, Haryana se hain. Yes, SK Yadav, we will go for a separate video also. So now we talk about literary theory concept, and we can stop the comments. Now all the online students, remember, focus what I'm teaching now. Okay, focus. Focus karna, that is more important. So I'll be briefing you about the concept of literary criticism. The literary criticism concept is also known as traditional criticism, because the traditional criticism kept the writer, the book, and the age always in the center. Means, whenever the literary critics like Plato, Aristotle, or Ben Jonson, Dryden, Pope, Arnold, Eliot, whenever they studied a piece of art, a poetry, a novel, a book, they always related it as an expression coming from an author, and author as an individual person living in a world. So technically, whenever they read or analyzed a book, they always kept this thing in the mind that writer is an individual, he has impressions on his mind, he is learning from society, and writer is just a medium expressing his views. So technically, it's the writer who is very important, because the book, the poetry, the novel, whatever you read, it is simply the result of a writer's brain. So keep the writer in the mind. Means, repeating once again, literary criticism, traditional criticism always believed that read any literary book, any piece of art, and relate it to the writer and get the exact meaning. All the students who are understanding me in Hindi, there are many students, they want me to speak the same thing in Hindi, because you were never taught literary theory, and I help my students by speaking in Hindi also. Pehle hi kya system tha ki kavita likhne wala kaun hai jisne kavita likhi hai, to hi wo kavita likhega. Like for example, have you ever wondered, in Ramcharitmanas, Tulsidas praises Lord Ram. Sirf Ramcharitmanas mein Bhagwan Ram ki tareef hai. Sita ke bare mein baatcheet nahi hoti. Sita ke bare mein no talk. No talk about Sita. But if you read about writer Tulsidas, you will find out that Tulsidas was insulted by his own wife. Tulsidas ki patni Ratnavali ne unka apman kiya tha. Ratnavali, his wife, insulted Tulsidas. And this is the reason that he was sick of. He was, you know, he was mad at all the womankind. And this was the reason in Ramcharitmanas, he did not praise any woman, any female lead. In Sita ko praise nahi kiya. But that's the wrong interpretation. Wrong interpretation. We say Wordsworth is the poet of nature. Wordsworth is the lover of nature, because Wordsworth lived his life in the lap of nature. That's why Wordsworth writes about nature. That is wrong. Plato believed that the great minds compose great literature. You should have great emotions. Why do you have to have great emotions? What if you don't have great emotions but you write something really well? The people, those who sit in the UPSC exam, they give the paper with the brain, not with their emotions. Dimag se padhte hain. So technically, traditional criticism had limitations, had issues. And this was the reason that they wanted something scientific, something very apt and up to the level. Like T.S. Eliot is a great writer, but T.S. Eliot was not at all emotional. In Wasteland, he himself has said that I use my brain, I use my learning. So T.S. Eliot used his brain and learning. He was not emotional about Wasteland. When Dickens wrote David Copperfield, he was very much emotional. So technically, if we say that a writer is involving his emotions, his background, his mindset, all of these things in his book, he is actually biased. He's not able to tell the truth. But when a reader reads a text and related to a great person or the writer or the author's personal life, we go for a wrong interpretation. Now, let's make it very easy for all my students. As I have given you the example in online class also, I have online class with example, the other the same thing. Suppose somebody tells you to buy a notebook written by Vineet Pandey, me, because in India, I am the only person with 8-time NET, double JRF, 17 state set. Somebody says that buy this booklet. One page, only one page booklet, buy it from Vineet Pandey, and he will tell you the secret to qualify NET. So many of you will think to buy, because you don't know what is in the book. You don't know that. The booklet is totally covered. You don't know it. What you know is, you know the name. So the text is in front of you, but you are not able to read the text. In fact, not willing to read the text. You know me, know my name, know the branding. You think he has written, so obviously something is good. And you will buy it. And if somebody comes to you and says, buy my book, and you find out that the person is only 1 or 2 time NET qualified or has no percentage, has never got JRF, you will not buy it. Because again, your approach is author based. So in both conditions, you did not read the text. Aapne padha hi nahi kitab ko. And that's how the wrong interpretation, the wrong reading took place. So this was the reason that न्यू क्रिटिसिज्म सॉरी द ट्रेडिशनल क्रिटिसिज्म और द क्लासिकल क्रिटिसिज्म गॉट इट्स लिमिटेशंस एंड अ न्यू थ्योरी इमर्ज्ड न्यू क्रिटिसिज्म इन 1920s एंड 30s. इन अमेरिका न्यू क्रिटिसिज्म गॉट अ मोमेंटम इन 1940s अंडर द लीडरशिप ऑफ जे सी रैंसम. दे आर ऑल्सो नोन एज वेंडरबिल्ट यूनिवर्सिटी स्कॉलर्स अग्रेरियंस सदर अग्रेरियंस एंड शिकागो क्रिटिक्स. नाउ रिमेंबर दिस पॉइंट. In new criticism, they came with a very basic idea. And please remember, don't forget this basic idea. They said book is autonomous. And from today onwards, we will study the book without taking any reference of the author, any reference of any great age, great mind, great connection. No connection at all. Now, many of us buy Apple products. So many of you want to buy iPhone, many of you already have it. Why do you want to buy an iPhone if you have not ever used it? Many of you are going to buy iPhones when you will qualify net. So if you have never used it, why do you want to buy? Because you have preconceived notions. Aapke anuman hai. Somebody praised it. Somebody told you it's costly. Somebody told you it's status symbol. So you did not use it. You have all the pretensions, all the ideas that it will be there if you have used it, you loved it, that's why you're buying it, right? So this is how New Criticism says that read the text. Chetan Bhagat wrote one book, he became very famous. Chetan Bhagat wrote second book, he became very famous. But now who remembers Chetan Bhagat? He's just a dance reality show judge without knowing how to dance. So if you buy another book, the 7th or the 10th book by Chetan Bhagat, just because he wrote two books which were good, then you are at the wrong side. And that's why New Criticism said that forget the writer, forget the author. Even if you remember the concept of Roland Barthes, the death of the author. Author did authorship, expressed himself, wrote the book. Now the book is the reality. Even the author doesn't know how and why he has created that book. That's the concept of literary theory, that even if the author says that I have written the book, he is not the writer. It is the act of writing which was found in the process of writing. The act of writing found in the process of writing. If you remember, I taught you today morning and I gave you the example of a love letter. Many of you must have written a love letter. So how do you write a love letter? When you write a love letter, you don't have a complete setup in your mind. What to write, how to write. If you like my example, don't forget to subscribe the channel. And that's my way how I teach. So how to find the content of writing during the process of writing? So how do you write a love letter? You don't have everything a plot in your mind that you write everything. You write one line, then you feel love, emotion. You have a lot to say. You are choosing words. Then you write second line. And again, you are thinking about a third line. You want to express so much love. Then you're choosing your words. And then when you have no idea about your fourth line, what do? You read your first line, second line, third line again to get the meaning of fourth line. So you read your letter. You're like, okay, this is too much show off. I can write something else. Then you again read your own letter. You must have done it in exams also. ऐसा नहीं हुआ एग्जाम में कि आपको लिखना नहीं आता, आप अपना ही आंसर पढ़ पढ़ के दोबारा सोचते हो अब आगे क्या लिखूं, अच्छा पहले क्या लिखा है, आगे क्या करूं, रीकैप करके करते हैं ना. दैट्स व्हाट वी कॉल इवन द राइटर्स, इवन द ऑथर्स फाइंड द एक्ट ऑफ राइटिंग इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ राइटिंग. सो टेक्निकली राइटर्स जॉब इज फिनिश्ड, इट्स द टेक्स्ट ओनली एंड टेक्स्ट इज ऑटोनॉमस. एंड हियर वी ऑलरेडी हैव स्टडीड न्यू क्रिटिसिज्म इन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. Now we talk about formalism. So new critics believe that read the text without any reference. Formalist studies, formalist writers, Austin Warren, he is very, very important, René Wellick, Roman Jakobson, they all came with the idea that when you are reading a text or a page, it has a structure, it has a form. Everything which has been arranged to convey a message has a structure. Har cheez ka ek structure hota hai, ye yaad rakhna. जब आप पोस्ट मॉडर्न्स पढ़ोगे, व्हेन यू विल स्टडी पोस्ट मॉडर्न्स, यू विल फाइंड आउट दैट देयर इज अ स्ट्रक्चर इन मोस्ट डिसऑर्गेनाइज्ड थिंग्स. जो चीजें ऑर्गेनाइज नहीं है, डिसऑर्गेनाइज्ड हैं, उसमें भी ऑर्गेनाइज चीजें मिलती हैं. फाइंडिंग ऑर्डर इन डिसऑर्डर्ड थिंग्स. रिमेंबर द फेमस लाइन, डिसऑर्डरली अ वुमन, फेमस बुक, इट्स अ साहित्य अकेडमी अवार्ड विनर. नाउ रिमेंबर दिस थिंग, इट्स बाय मालती राव, इफ यू डोंट नो दैट. फाइंडिंग ऑर्डर इन डिसऑर्डर्ड थिंग्स. सो हाउ डू यू फाइंड दैट ऑर्डर इन अ पेज यू विल फाइंड वर्ड्स. सो फॉर्मलिज्म क्या बोलता है, इट्स अ फॉर्म ओरिएंटेड अप्रोच. दे से दैट ऑन अ पेज देर इज अ लाइन, देर इज सिंटेक्स, देर इज ग्रामर, देर इज लिटरेरी टर्म्स, लिटरेरी डिवाइसेज, राइम स्कीम्स, ट्रॉप्स एंड ऑल दीज काइंड ऑफ अदर थिंग्स विच मेक अ लैंग्वेज इफेक्टिव, विच मेक अ लैंग्वेज अलाइव. सो वेन यू आर रीडिंग अ टेक्स्ट डोंट गो फॉर जस्ट बेसिक रीडिंग, गो फॉर अ फॉर्मल रीडिंग. रीड द फॉर्म स्ट्रक्चर मीन्स फॉर्म ओरिएंटेड अप्रोच. नाउ लेट्स मेक इट ईजी इन विनीत पांडे स्टाइल. Whenever you did critical appreciation of a line, poetry given in your exams, what did you do? You talked about the content. You read it twice, thrice and elaborated the content in exam. That is new criticism. And when you actually found the literary devices, alliterations, we generally find alliterations. It's easy to find the consonant sounds. We found pun. We found some other similes and metaphors. That is called forms oriented study. So you have been doing, you are already doing the new criticism study and formalist study. It's a basic thing, you are already doing it. When what would you know, what would happen in the exams when you were giving your post graduation exam and there was a line from some poetry but you did not know the writer, what did you do? Aap exam de rahe ho, ek paragraph aa gaya poetry ka aur aapko nahi pata ki poetry kahan se aati hai line hai. So how do we talk in exam? We ask our friends left and right, brother, please tell me the writer. So you have a poetry, a paragraph in front of you in the paper, and you are, instead of having the lines, which is same line for you, for your friend, for others in the exam, why are you asking the name of the writer? You must have done it. Kitne logon ne aisa kiya hai, batao. कितने लोगों ने ऐसा किया है, जब एग्जाम पेपर में पैराग्राफ आता था, पोइट्री आती थी, तो आप अगल बगल वाले से राइटर का नाम पूछते थे. अभी देखते हैं, जल्दी से बताओ. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव चीटेड इन एग्जाम्स वेन एवर देर वॉज द लाइन्स ऑफ पोइट्रीज एंड पैराग्राफ्स एंड यू ट्राइड टू फाइंड आउट द राइटर दे कम फ्रॉम द बिलोंग टू. किसने किया है? किया ना, आस्था जी ने किया. आस्था जी वेरी ऑनेस्ट. बबली वर्मा जी ने किया, बहुत ऑनेस्ट है, बहुत बढ़िया, शाबाश. राजीव कुमार जी जवाब दीजिए. चिंका मीना ने नहीं किया, करना चाहिए था भाई. अवनीश इज वेरी इंटेलिजेंस. प्रियंका बहुत बढ़िया. विवेक शुक्ला बहुत बढ़िया, शाबाश, किया ना. अरे मैं भी करता था यार लेफ्ट राइट में. यस अतुल मिश्रा. सो लेट्स अज्यूम, थोड़ा मैं, लेट मी गेट इन्वॉल्व इन प्रॉपर टीचिंग. इट्स लाइक टीचिंग माय स्टूडेंट्स नाउ. सो लेट्स अज्यूम योर फ्रेंड सेड हाय दीज लाइंस आर फ्रॉम वर्ड्सवर्थ. Now you have lines in front of you, but you're not reading lines. You're asking the writer. Writer tells you, tells you it's Wordsworth. And now you all know the answer. You'll be like, Wordsworth is a nature poet. Wordsworth is a great poet. Wordsworth lived in the lap of nature. Wordsworth talks about clouds, mountains, rivers. And you will write a lot because you don't know the lines, you know Wordsworth. Your teachers have taught you about Wordsworth in Romanticism. What if the same person says after 10 minutes that, sorry, it's not Wordsworth, it's T.S. Eliot. All of a sudden, you will have to cut your pages. And what will you do? T.S. Eliot is a modern writer with complex thoughts and process. He had chosen the vocabulary which is very complex. He talks about the modernity. He talks about the barrenness of society, the modernness which has killed the culture. And all of a sudden, again, you did not read the lines. You went for the author. You went for the writer. This was the reason. This was the issue that new criticism took place. So always remember this concept, right? So now we talk about the formal structure of formalism. Formal studies. It said that language plays a game of the words. Language can be elusive. Language is something that creates an ambivalence. And it is the language in the text which is very, very important. So formalist studies ne kya kiya, formal structure padhne ke liye bola ki language ko padho, language ko. And here, the writers who supported the concept that it is the language which is very, very important, they formed a new school, Moscow Linguistic Circle. Later, it became Prague Linguistic Circle. Now put the title, Prague Linguistic Circle. Ab yahan pe likho, Prague Linguistic Circle. मोहम्मद सवरीन, बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस आते हैं लिटरेरी थ्योरी से. यस, टेक्स्ट इज मेड अप ऑफ लिंग्विस्टिक्स. लैंग्वेज इज इंपॉर्टेंट. Prague linguistic circle. So first, earlier it was Tartu Maru school, then under the guidance of Bokarovsky, then Roman Jakobsen, then we have Mikhail Bakhtin. All of these guys, they form a group together and which was known as Prague Linguistic Circle. Prague Literary Circle, Prague Linguistic Circle. P-R-A-G-U-E, Prague. Now, they said that language plays very important role, but language is something which is not smooth, which has a different identity. Because if a language is regularly used again and again, it becomes very smooth, it becomes very conventional, and nobody minds that. So technically, there are two types of language that Russian formalists believed in. Russian formal writers ne kya kiya? Do type ki language hoti hai. Kaun kaun si type ki do language hoti hai? Primary order language and secondary order language. So what are those two types of languages? Primary order language and secondary order language. Now tell me this thing. Have you ever wondered that there are two types of languages? Primary order and secondary order. Kabhi socha hai aapne aisa? Primary order language bhi hai, secondary order language bhi hai. There are two types of language. Have you ever purchased any dictionary saying, sir, please give me the dictionary of secondary order language? कभी किसी ने कहा है आपको कि प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज में बात करो, टॉक टू मी इन प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज. सो हाउ विल यू डिफरेंशिएट व्हाट इज प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज, व्हाट इज सेकेंडरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज? हु नोज इट? कम ऑन, लेट्स सी. प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज क्या होता है, सेकेंडरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज क्या होता है? कभी सुना नहीं ना प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज, सेकेंडरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज क्या होता है? लेट्स मेक इट वेरी इजी. थैंक यू गुरप्रीत जी. सो प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज क्या होता है, अब ध्यान से देखो. इन प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज यू हैव डेली कम्युनिकेशन. इट डज नॉट हैव हिडन मीनिंग, इट डज नॉट हैव सिम्बॉलिक मीनिंग, इट हैज द मीनिंग विच इज मोमेंट्री एंड इन प्रेजेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट. यानी कि अब देसी भाषा में बात करते हैं, देसी भाषा में बात करते हैं. प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज का मतलब होता है बातचीत की भाषा, डेली कम्युनिकेशन. प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज मीन्स डेली कम्युनिकेशन, ठीक है, बातचीत समझ लो. यानी कि डेली यूज की लैंग्वेज विच हैज नो हिडन मीनिंग एट ऑल. व्हाट इज सेकेंडरी यूज ऑफ लैंग्वेज? नाउ हाउ टू फाइंड आउट वेदर द लैंग्वेज सेकेंडरी, हाउ टू फाइंड आउट वेदर द लैंग्वेज इज सेकेंडरी? डू वी हैव सम डिफरेंट वोकैबुलरी ऑफ सेकेंडरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज? डू वी हैव प्रॉपर फ्रेजेस फॉर सेकेंड ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज? नो. Now, here we go for one of my best examples, and let's see, let's talk about it. Change can't be given to you every time. You must bring the change. Write it. Ekta ji, aisa kuch nahi hai. Dobara se padhaunga main, suniyega. Change can't be given to you every time. You must bring the change. What is this? Many of you are giving your own ideas, but ऐसा नहीं है. हाँ साधना, ये ऑनलाइन क्लास पढ़ा चुका हूँ मैं आपको, तो आई एम श्योर आपको आता होगा. सो चेंज कांट बी गिवन टू यू एवरी टाइम, यू मस्ट ब्रिंग द चेंज. ऑल द न्यू स्टूडेंट्स टेल मी, ये तो आता होगा ऑनलाइन स्टूडेंट्स को, तो आता है. आई नो दे आर सेइंग गांधी जी के डायलॉग है. गांधी जी सेड दिस थिंग, चेंज कांट बी गिवन टू यू एवरी टाइम, यू मस्ट ब्रिंग द चेंज. What do you mean by it, all the new students? Come on, I'm waiting for answers. I'm reading your answers here. Very good, Atul Mishra. Neeraj Kumar remembers my lecture. Raina Sarkar remembers my lecture. Sonali ko bhi online lecture yaad hai. दिस इज द बेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. आपको सबको अच्छे से चीजें याद है यहाँ. बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत बढ़िया. सो टेल मी दिस थिंग ऑल द न्यू स्टूडेंट्स, गांधी जी सेड चेंज कांट बी गिवन टू यू एवरी टाइम, यू मस्ट ब्रिंग द चेंज. कैन वी कॉल इट अ प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज और अ सेकेंडरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज? लेट्स सी हाउ मेनी ऑफ न्यू स्टूडेंट्स आंसर दिस थिंग. कैन वी से इट्स अ प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज और सेकेंडरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज? कितने न्यू स्टूडेंट्स ऐसे, ओनली फॉर न्यू स्टूडेंट्स. ऑनलाइन स्टूडेंट्स आर ऑलरेडी आंसरिंग ऑल दीज थिंग्स. न्यू स्टूडेंट्स आर सेइंग सेकेंडरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज. ओके, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू बिलीव इट्स प्राइमरी ऑर्डर विच? अरे इतने सारे न्यू स्टूडेंट्स हैं, सभी सेकेंडरी बोल रहे हैं. प्राइमरी ऑर्डर है. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू बिलीव इट इज प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज? जय घोष बताओ. जय घोष इज गोइंग टू टेल अस, इजंट इट प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज? अमिताज ने सही आंसर किया. अमिताज इज एन ओल्ड स्टूडेंट, वेरी गुड. प्रतिभा जी स्वागत है. ओके सो नाउ फोकस. Change can't be given to you every time. You must bring the change. It means the change in society, it should be brought by you. So technically, it's a great message. It's a hidden message. And this becomes secondary order language. But when I said Mahatma Gandhi says this thing, you believe that Mahatma Gandhi always talks about great things. So that's why it becomes secondary order. But what if Mahatma Gandhi was going to meet Britishers in the police station? He took an auto, and while getting out of the auto, he said, change can't be given to you every time, you must bring the change. Kripya paise khulle deve, please give me the coins, the money, the change. So Gandhiji is talking to auto wala and saying that change can't be given to you every time, you must bring the change. Now tell me, is this a secondary order language or a daily communication language? बताओ क्या गांधी जी ऑटो वाले से बात नहीं कर सकते? Is it sure that Gandhi ji will always speak something big and good? He can talk to an auto wala also, and to an auto wala he can say this thing that change can't be given to you every time, you must bring the change. प्रेमचंद जी कह रहे गांधी जी स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड थे. सो इट डजंट मैटर वेदर गांधी जी इज सेइंग दिस थिंग और समवन एल्स इज सेइंग दिस थिंग. व्हाट मैटर्स इज द कॉन्टेक्स्ट, इन विच पर्टिकुलर कॉन्टेक्स्ट, एट व्हाट टाइम, ड्यूरिंग व्हाट सिचुएशन इट वाज सेड. सो इफ यू हैव अ माइक, थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पीपल आर लिसनिंग एंड यू आर सेइंग चेंज कांट बी गिवन टू यू एवरी टाइम, यू मस्ट ब्रिंग द चेंज, देन पीपल विल अंडरस्टैंड that you are asking a change in society. Aisa nahi hoga that thousands of people will start taking currency, coins. So context will decide whether it is primary order language or secondary order language. Always remember this thing. The language primary order, secondary order, they are same words, same vocabulary, same language. It is the context which will decide. Now I'm going to tell you a very funny example. I'm sure you would love my teaching. And remember this thing. Always remember this is called Vineet Pandit style. A father, he came back from his office and asked the elder son to give him a glass of water. So father came from office, called his elder son. He said, beta, get me a glass of water. The elder son was very blunt and denied. He said, Papa, apne aap le lo. Seeing this thing, that elder son has disrespected father, younger son, he came and started shouting at the elder one. He said that, Papa, this man is a lazy fellow. He has disrespected you. He did not give you water. Now please, you go to kitchen, take water and get one glass for me. छोटे लड़के ने बोला, पापा तो बदतमीज है, एक काम करो आप खुद भी पानी ले लो और एक गिलास मेरे लिए भी ले आना. अब दोनों में असली बदतमीज कौन था? सो व्हेन एल्डर वन डिनाइड दैट आई विल नॉट डू इट, इट वाज प्राइमरी ऑर्डर लैंग्वेज, ही डिनाइड ब्लंटली. बट द सेकंड वन प्लेड इन अ लिटररी वे. सो यंगर सन्स एक्सप्रेशन इज सेकेंडरी ऑर्डर बिकॉज इट हैज अ लॉट टू से, अ लॉट टू स्पीक. Always, you'll always remember my way. Got it? Primary order language, secondary order language. Secondary order language has hidden meanings, hidden message. So the elder son denied bluntly. That was very direct, very simple daily communication, that I will not give you water. younger one created a plot, created a suspense, and then surprisingly said that you go take water and give me. So second one. Okay, thank you so much, those who are praising my teaching style. Thank you so much. I love teaching and literary theory padhane maza aata hai. Now the last and final example of primary order and secondary order, because defamiliarization, the concept, how to understand. Suppose you are not able to judge the context, or suppose 10-15 people, they are talking to each other, you don't know how to make your speech special. How do you make your speech special? You must have seen in college strikes. College ki strikes dekhiye, aapne hartal dekhiye. The leader who never speaks in a good language starts speaking in a very loud, in a good language, calling you brothers and sisters. There are some code words. All the politicians, they use it. Bhaiyo, behno. So these code words, brothers and sisters, comrades, these code words, they differentiate the language. So there are some different ways. You can raise your voice, so differentiate your language from others. You can change the language you speak. Now, suppose if today you go back and you talk to your father and mother and you say, Mata Shri, Pita Shri, Paniko, you call Jal. You start speaking very pure Hindi. Your parents will be surprised. They'll be like, what happened? They'll start paying attention. They'll look at you, what has happened? And this is how your language will seek attention and will become secondary order language. You must have read novels. Sometimes there are some lines in italics. That is also secondary order style. To make defamiliar. Suppose we all are talking, nobody is listening, then one raises voice. In a fight, in a verbal quarrel, one raises voice so that others can listen to him. So he is making the language defamiliar. We all have people, we all have a habit of making our voice strange so that people listen to us. This is how we call it defamiliarization. And the very easy new example of defamiliarizing I'm going to give you, also known as alienation concept. So there was a Hindi professor and he wanted his bicycle to have some air. His the tire of the bicycle didn't have any air. And he was a Hindi professor. Ek Hindi ke shikshak ko cycle mein hawa bharwani thi. Wo cycle wale ke paas gaya aur bola, dhyan se suna. He dwi chakriya vahan sudharak mahoday. मेरे द्विचक्रीय वाहन के द्वितीय चक्र में वायु का दबाव कुछ कम प्रतीत होता है, अतः अपने वायु ठूसक यंत्र की लिबलिबी से इसमें मुझे कुछ वायु ठूस कर अनुग्रहित करें. हिंदी टीचर स्पोक इन हिंदी, बट यू नो व्हाट डिड दैट पंक्चर वाला सेड. ही सेड, यू लुक अ गुड मैन, व्हाई आर यू बेगिंग हियर. आप तो अमीर आदमी लगते हो, भीख क्यों मांग रहे हो. व्हाट वॉज द फॉल्ट ऑफ द हिंदी टीचर? He spoke purest form of Hindi, very pure form of Hindi. See the students, they are loving it. Itne sare smileys aa rahe hain. Khali tareef hi kar rahe ho, status pe to likhte nahi ho kahin. Na Facebook pe share karte ho, batate to ho nahi logon ko. If you love this lecture, आज इसको share करना Facebook पे, write a post for me and tag hashtag करके विनीत पांडे. I'll see. I'm sure you are loving it. I'm sure आप हंस रहे हो. Thank you जी. So that's what he said, right? So technically, we all speak Hindi. So in a Hindi speaking scenario, if you are speaking in Hindi, how your language becomes alienated? The professor spoke in Hindi, which was not used in present time. That Hindi was used in Mahabharata, in Ramayana, right? So if you have chosen some vocab, some wordings which are different, it will become, your language will become totally different. Like the language of the doctors, medicines, language of the law, they use, you know, the words muwakkil and applicant and warranty, these kind of words. So that's how it becomes defamiliarizing concept. Now remember this thing, that along with these things, they also believe, primarily Mikhail Bakhtin, he believes in this concept that language has multiple voices. which is called polyphony, multiple voices, and it creates dialogism. So the right meaning always comes after dialogism. जो राइट मीनिंग है वो डायलॉजिज्म के बाद आता है. नाउ कॉन्सेप्ट गिवन बाय मिखाइल बाख्तिन, व्हाट इज डायलॉजिज्म? डायलॉजिज्म इज व्हेन वी हैव टू वॉइसेस, टू पीपल स्पीकिंग टू ईच अदर, बट व्हेन टू पीपल इज बेटर. इफ यू आर रीडिंग अ ड्रामा, इन ड्रामा देर आर मेनी कैरेक्टर्स, एवरी कैरेक्टर हैज एन ओपिनियन, हर कैरेक्टर एक ओपिनियन देता है. बींग अ रीडर, हाउ विल यू अंडरस्टैंड विच ओपिनियन इज योर्स? सो डायलॉजिज्म सेज दैट रीडर, listener has access of these two different voices. He reads them, he listens to them, and finds his meaning. It's like, for example, G.B. Shaw, famous book Candida. G.B. Shaw's famous book Candida, you all must have studied. All the online students who have completed Modern Age with us, they must have studied. Now remember this, in G.B. Shaw's Candida, what happens? A lover, he comes and claims his love for the lady. Eugene Marchbank comes and says that I love Candida. Candida's husband, he says she's my wife, and they start having a debate. So lover has his points. He says, I will take care of your wife. She's young. You don't praise her. I will praise her. I will love her. Husband says, I am giving her social security, social life, social respect. And both of them have proper opinions. Now we don't know what to do. So listening to both of these, we will find the third meaning. And in the Candida, third meaning is given by Candida herself. In dialogism, there are many voices. We must understand the concept of monologism before we understand dialogism. And remember, the concept of monologism is also given by Mikhail Bakhtin. All the online students will be getting PDF. Aapko sabko PDF mil jayega. So you'll find out everything. You don't have to worry. Monologism means one voice, authoritative voice, one person speaking. You can't do anything, you have to follow it. The short story writers. Now, I'll be giving you a famous example. Thakur Ka Kuan, written by Prem Chand, talks about a poor person. He was a Dalit and was not allowed to fetch water from the well of upper caste. And the lady tries to fetch some water from the well of upper caste, but then she runs away. And in the end of the story, we find that the Dalit man is drinking water from the drainage. So when we read the story, we all of a sudden have anger against the upper caste. Because in the entire story, the upper caste Thakur does not appear. It's only the mentioning. He is not a character. Writer simply presents two characters, husband and wife. Then the story is about the upper caste character, but the character doesn't appear. Now, what if the same story is written by G.B. Shaw? Because G.B. Shaw always kept two perspectives. G.B. Shaw hamesha dono ko bolne ka mauka deta tha. And Thakur also gets a proper chance, honest chance to speak. Suppose the Dalits say that we want water, and Thakur says, no, I will not give you water. Yesterday I allowed you to take water to drink, but you were swimming in my well with a lot of sabun and shampoo, and you made my water dirty. That's why I'm not allowing you. So will you feel the same bad emotions for Thakur? No, because now you have second opinion. So until unless you have two different voices, two different opinions, you never get the right meaning of the text. Whenever you have a debate, there is opposition, which is always required, because the leading one and the opposition, they have a debate, and debate lets you get more messages. That's called dialogism. In monologism, in short stories, in Premchand or Anton Chekhov or Alice Munro, they have simply given one narration, one voice narration. Monologism does not tell you the truth. The real meaning is found when we have dialogic information, dialogism. Now I'll make it very easy. Many of you are mothers, those who are watching my video. Many of you have kids. So, theek hai. Ab dekho. Two kids, they fight. And then they go to mother and complain. Like, I am also having one brother, one sister. I remember my childhood. We would fight and then one of us would approach mother. So, suppose I reached first. What will I say? Will I tell the truth or I will tell the manipulated truth? कौन सा सच बताऊंगा, असली सच बताऊंगा या एक मैनेज करके अच्छे से सच बताऊंगा, कौन सा सच बताऊंगा? टेल मी दिस थिंग, इफ देर आर टू किड्स फाइटिंग एंड वन ऑफ देम आफ्टर द फाइट रीचेस टू द मदर, व्हाट विल ही से? ही विल टेल द ट्रूथ और द मैनिपुलेटेड ट्रूथ? बताओ, आई एम वेटिंग फॉर यू. द मैनिपुलेटेड वन, यस. ही विल नॉट टेल द ट्रूथ. ही विल से, मॉम, ही वॉज हिटिंग मी फर्स्ट, ही वॉज सेइंग दिस थिंग, ही वॉज टीजिंग मी. सो कैन यू से दैट द मदर विल लिसन टू द एल्डर वन, द फर्स्ट वन, एंड विल बीट द सेकेंड वन? नो. फर्स्ट वन गेव हिज नरेशन, क्रिएटेड स्टोरी फ्रॉम हिज पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, हाईलाइटेड स्टोरी फ्रॉम हिज पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, एंड नोइंगली ओमिटेड स्टोरी फ्रॉम हिज पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. देन द यंगर वन रीचेज, अब छोटा वाला जाता है, यंगर वन टेल्स अनदर स्टोरी, अगेन अ मैनिपुलेटेड ट्रूथ, हाईलाइटिंग सम पॉइंट्स, देन मेकिंग सम पॉइंट्स ऑब्स्क्योर एंड टेलिंग द स्टोरी. नाउ मदर विल कॉल बोथ ऑफ देम, कम हियर, एंड दे बोथ विल स्पीक टूगेदर, एक्यूज ईच अदर, एंड हियर मदर विल फाइंड आउट द रियल मीनिंग, दैट हु इज द रियल रेस्पॉन्सिबल पर्सन बिहाइंड दिस, राइट? दिस इज कॉल्ड डायलॉजिक इंटरप्रिटेशन. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस थिंग? Tell me if you understood this thing. So, we'll be dealing with 2-3 more terms: carnival, heteroglossia, monolism, dialogism. We have done polyphony and French formalism in next video. I thought I'll be able to sum up, but it has crossed limit, and we have issues of battery now. So, wait for my another live session. We will go for it. All the new students are invited to join the fresh batch starting very soon. WhatsApp me on 8881028 9637 and I'll be responding you. All the new students, you are simply requested कि आप मुझे 8881028 9637 पे मैसेज कीजिए, आप हमारा बैच ज्वाइन कर सकते हैं. With this message, thank you so much. सभी इसको हटा दीजिए. Thank you.